Okay, see here everybody, today we are going to see some problems which are depend on the concept SSS condition. Okay, so example is written, already we have seen theorem which is related to SSS condition. Okay, and we have seen some examples also. Okay, now today we are going to see some example which are depend on the same concept. Okay, so here what is given, if two isosceles triangles have common base, prove that the line joining their vertices bisects them at right angles, bisect them at right angles. Okay, here we have to prove this. Now see what is given, if two isosceles triangle, here two figures are given because both the figures are satisfying the given information. Okay, so or with the help of given information we can construct both the figures. Okay, so see here, two isosceles triangle have common base. Here see, triangle ABC and triangle BDC are isosceles triangles. Okay, and common base, both having common base BC. Okay, so and here also if you will see, triangle ABC and triangle DBC are isosceles triangle and both are standing on the common base BC. Okay, the difference between both the figures is the both the iso, here in first figure both the isosceles triangles are opposite sides of the base and here on the same side of the base. Okay, so that is only difference, otherwise the solution for both the figures is same. Okay, so first we will take whatever given things are there. So given, if two isosceles triangles have common base, two isosceles triangles are given. So triangle ABC, triangle ABC and triangle BDC, BDC are isosceles triangle on the common base, on the common base BC. Okay, both are on the common base BC. Now what we have to prove, prove that the line joining their vertices bisect them at right angles. Okay, prove that the line joining their vertices bisect them at right angles. Okay, line joining means here we need to prove that AD bisects BC, AD bisects BC, AD bisect BC means we need to prove BE is equal to EC, BE is equal to EC, this we need to prove, and bisect them at right angle means here we need to prove angle AEB or AEC is equal to 90 degree, AEB or this or this or this, bisect them at a right angle. So we can just, I am writing here AEB is equal to AEC equals to 90 degree, this we have to prove. Okay, we need to prove this angle is 90 degree. The same thing is here. Okay, what is given here, AD bisect BC, AD, AD bisect BC, AD here for four, second figure we need to produce AE to point E. Okay, we need to produce AD to point E, when it will, then only it will bisect to the EC, base EC, BC. Okay, so now we will see solution, that is proof, proof. Okay, so first we need to think about how we can give the proof. So we need to think about the solution. Okay, so we need to prove BE and EC equal, BE and EC are equal, that we need to show, that is first thing, and then we have to show this angle, both the angles are 90 degree or one angle is 90 degree, that is enough. Okay, so here if you'll observe, triangle ABC and BDC are standing on the same base. Okay, if due to AD, okay, due to AD, the whole figure is divided into two triangles, okay, which two triangles, triangle ABD and triangle ACD, triangle ABD and triangle ACD. Okay, in that what is given, AB and AC are equal, that is given because isosceles triangle, BD and DC are equal because BDC is also an isosceles triangle, and AD is common for both the triangles. So by SSS criteria, SSS, side, we can say both the triangles are congruent. Okay, if we will prove both the triangles are congruent, or we can prove, this way we can prove triangles are congruent, then we can say both these two angles, angle this and this angle, this and these angles are congruent by CPCT, by CPCT, okay. Now, after that, if you will think about triangle AEB and triangle AEC, AEB and AEC, that also we can prove both triangles are congruent, okay. Now, which criteria we will use to prove AEB and AEC? In that, AB is equal to AC, again we can use, AE is equal to AE, with common side, this angle, angle BAE and CAE are equal, because just now we have given proof for that, by CPCT we have told. So, by side angle side, both the triangles are congruent, okay. If both the triangles, triangle AEB and triangle AEC are congruent, then we can say BE is equal to CE by CPCT, okay. And we can say AEB is equal to AEC, CPCT, okay. But AEB and AEC are forming linear pair, so the sum of both the angles will be 180 degree. So, that we can take this plus this is equal to 180 degree, but both angles are same. So, that way we can show angles are 90 degree, okay, bisecting at 90 degree, okay. So, see here once again carefully. First, we are thinking about triangle, in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, ACD we have AB is equal to AC, AB is equal to AC, because it is given isosceles triangle, so that we can write BD is equal to DC, okay. So that is also given means triangle ABC and triangle BDC, ABC, triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle, okay. Triangle BDC is also an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle, okay. And third thing, AD is the common side for both the triangles, so that we can write AD is equal to AD, okay. So with the help of these three things, that this reason is common side, with the help of this side we can say triangle ABD congruent triangle ACD by side by SSS condition, both the triangles are congruent. Okay, now here we have told ABD and ACD are common, ABD and ACD are congruent triangle, not common, congruent triangle, okay. So now after this, what we can show, ABD and ACD over, so here I am saying this is suppose angle 1 and this I am saying angle 2, this I am saying angle 2. So can we write angle 1 is equal to angle 2, angle 1 and angle 2? Because triangles are congruent, so corresponding angles are also congruent. So we can see here by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle, angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Okay. Now we will think about triangle ABE, in triangle ABE and triangle ACE, ACE, triangle ABE and ACE, AB is equal to AC, angle, sorry, side AB is equal to AC, okay, AB is equal to AC, this is given because triangles are isosceles, both the triangles are isosceles, so AB and AC are equal, okay. Now here for this we are saying here this is 1, then angle 1 is equal to angle 2, angle 1 is equal to angle 2, why? From 1, here we have told angle 1 and angle 2, okay, reason is also given, so here from 1 we can write, so here direct I am taking from 1, and AE is the common side for both the triangles. So AE is equal to AE. This is common side. So again we can say by side angle side, by SAS criteria, triangle ABE congruent triangle ACE by side angle side, by SAS criteria both the triangles are congruent. Okay. Triangle AEB and triangle AEC are congruent. Okay, so now we can say BE is equal to CE. BE is equal to CE. BE and CE are equal by CPCT. Also, we can say AEB and AEC. So, I am directly here taking angle 3 and this I am saying angle 4. Okay, so directly I can write angle 3 is equal to angle 4 by CP CD, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Two triangles are congruent, so corresponding angles are same and sides BE is equal to CE. Okay, so we said here both the things with the help of CP CD. Okay, so now we can see here, if you will observe figure, then we can get here AEB is equal to AEC, that is angle 3 and angle 4 are equal, but angle 3 and angle 4 are forming linear pair also. So sum of both the angles will be 180 degrees. So I am taking here angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degrees, because angle 3 and angle 4 are forming linear pair. So linear pair means supplementary angle. So addition of will be 180 degrees. So here this I am saying this is second one. This is second one. Okay. Angle 3 and angle 4 are equal. Angle 3 and angle 4 are equal. So I am taking angle 3 plus angle, instead of angle 4, I am taking angle 3 is equal to 180 degree. So 2 times angle 3. 2 times angle 3 is equal to 180 degree. So angle 3 is equal to 180 divided by 2. So it is 180 divided by 2 means 90 degree. Angle 3 is equal to 90 degree. 3 means what? AEB or AEC also we can say, or BED and CED. All the 4 angles will be, each of the 4 angle will be 90 degree. So I am seeing here angle AEB is equal to 90 degree. Okay. So both the things we have shown here, AE is equal to BE is equal to EC. B is equal to EC also we have given, that only we were going to prove. And third, next thing is angles bisecting at right angle. Okay. So this was the proof. See carefully and solve once again in your notebook. Okay, see here our second problem is, a point O is taken inside an equilateral four sides figure ABCD, such that its distance from the angular point D and B are equal. Show that AO and OC are in one and the same straight line. Okay, so this is the this problem is given, statement is given and figure is given. Okay, so once again we will see the statement and figure. Okay, a point O is taken inside an equilateral four sides figure ABCD. ABCD is a figure whose all the four sides are equal, that is given. Okay, equilateral four side means AB is equal to AD is equal to DC and is equal to BC. This is first thing is given, such that its distance from the angular D and B are equal. Okay, it's such that its distance from the angular points D and B are equal. Okay, D are equal means what? OB is equal to OD. They have told us that is given. OB and OD are equal. Okay, now show that AO and OC are in one and the same straight line. AO and OC are in one and straight line. Okay, that we have to show. That is our target. Okay, so first given things I am taking on the blackboard. So first, what is given? A point O is taken inside an equilateral four sides figure. Okay, O is inside an equilateral four sides figure ABCD. Okay, O is inside of the figure ABCD. Okay, and what is given? Such that its distance from the angular point D and B are equal. Means what is given? DO is equal to BO. This is given. DO and BO are equal. That is given. Okay. Now we have to show that given, and to prove, we have to show show that AO and OC are in one and the same straight line. AO and OC are in one and the same straight line. One and the same straight line. Okay. Instead of that, we can write in short also. Okay. But we must understand what is the meaning of this statement. Okay. AO and OC are on the same straight line. Means what we need to show, if you'll understand what actually we need to show according to the figure or given statement, then only we can find out solution properly. Okay. So according to this, see, AO and OC are in one and the same straight line. Straight line. Straight line means what? If I want to prove AO and OC are on the same straight line or only one line, then what I need to show? These two angles, the sum of these two angles, sum of these two or these two is 180 degree. Okay. Means here I need to show AOD plus DOC is equal to 180 degree. If it is 180 degree, then that is a straight line. Understood? So that is our target. So according to that, we need to show. So I am taking here in short. Suppose here I am taking, this is angle 1. This I am taking angle 1 and this is point O. This is point O I am taking here. This is angle 2. This is angle 3 and this is angle 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So in short, I need to show that angle 1 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degree, or angle 2 plus angle 3 is equal to 180 degree. Any one statement if you'll prove, then that is enough. Okay. So now we will see proof. Okay. So first, what we will do, we will take triangle AOD and triangle AOB. Both the triangles we will take. Okay. Why we are going to take both the triangles? See here, AOD and AOB. If you will take both the triangles, these two triangles, then AD is equal to AB. That is given because four sides are equal. So AD and AB are equal. We can write reason given. Then OD is equal to OB. That is also given. And OA is the common side for both the triangles. So by SSS criteria, we can say this and this triangle is congruent. Okay. Both the triangles are congruent. Now see, then we can say angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. Angle 1 and angle 2 are equal by CPCT. By CPCT. The same thing we will use for these two triangles. Triangle DOC and triangle BOC. In that, what is given? OC is equal to OC. Common side. Then DC is equal to BC. Equal because it is given. And OD is equal to OB, same because it is also given. So by SSS criteria, these two triangles are equal. If these two triangles are equal, then we can say angle 3 and angle 4 are equal by CPCT. Okay. So after that, what we can do? This is whole angle. Whole angle is equal to 360 degree. 360 degree means what? Four right angles. Okay, so angle 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is equal to 360, or 4 right angles also we can write. But angle 1 and 2 are equal, so we can write 2 times angle 1 plus angle 4 and 3 are equal, means we can write 2 times angle 4 is equal to 360, or 4 right angles. So 2 we can take common, and then we can show angle 1 and angle plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so see carefully. Once I am showing here, first we will take in triangle AOD and triangle AOD and triangle AOB. Triangle AOD and triangle AOB. AD is equal to AB. AD and AB are equal because that is given. Then we can say OD and OB are equal. OD is equal to OB because that is also given. And next thing, AO is equal to AO is equal to AO because that is common side. That is common side. So we can say triangle AOD congruent triangle AOB by SSS. Side criteria. Both the triangles are congruent. If both the triangles are congruent, then we can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. This I am saying here, first one, and that is reason is CPCT. By CPCT, both the triangles are congruent. Okay, same thing we will use DCO and BCO in triangle DCO and triangle BCO. Okay, so now in triangle DCO and BCO, which things are same? DC is equal to BC. DC and BC are equal because that is given. So here we can give reason given. Then OD is equal to OB. OD is equal to OB. That is also given. And OC is equal to OC. OC is equal to OC. This is common side. This is common side for both the triangles. Okay. So now with the help of these three things, we can write triangle DCO congruent triangle BCO by SSS. Side, both the triangles are congruent. Okay. Now we know that this is forming the 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 will be 360 degree. 360 means what? 4 right angles. So that I am taking here angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4. Okay, is equal to 360 degree. But before this, what we will do here, before this we need to show here angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Angle 3 and angle 4 are equal. Okay, this I am saying second one, and the reason is CPCT, corresponding part of congruent triangle. Okay, if these two triangles are equal, angle 3 and angle 4 are equal by CPCT. Okay, so now after this we can see here angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 4 right angles. 4 right angles means what? 4 right angles means 360 degree. Okay, or directly 360 degree also we can write. But angle 1 and 2 are equal. Angle 1 and 2 are equal. So instead of angle 1 plus angle 2, I am taking here angle 1 plus angle 1 plus 3 and 4 are equal. 3 and 4 are equal. So angle 1 I have taken 2 times. So angle 4 I will take. Instead of angle 3, I am taking angle 4 plus angle 4 is equal to 4 right angles, or 360 degree we can write. So here angle 1 plus angle 1, 2 times angle 1 plus 2 times angle 4 is equal to 4 right angles. Okay, so 2 we can take common. 2 we can take common, that is 2 in bracket angle 1 plus angle 4 is equal to 4 right angles. 4 right angles. Okay, so 2 when we will take this side, that time 4 divided by 2 is 2. So angle 1 plus angle 4 is equal to 2 right angles. 2 right angles means 90 degree. Okay, 2 90 degree angles. So it is 180 degree angle. So angle 1 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degree. If angle 1 plus 4 is equal to 180 degree, then we can say AOC are on the same line. Okay, or AOC, what they are asking, AO and OC are in one and the same straight line. So from this we can say AO and OC are on the same line. Sames are forming the same straight line. Okay, straight line means straight angle is 180 degree. So here we can say AO and OC are in one and the same straight line. Got it, everybody? Thank you.